What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Third Person. This is the Third Person Podcast. My name is Chris, and with me, as always, is Mike.
That's me.
Guys, yeah, Fear the Walking Dead, Season 3, Episode 12, Brother's Keeper.
Yes.
All right. So,
no.
We got a comment that one of our followers was like, one of our viewers is like, you know what, man, fuck this show, but I'll stick with you guys and watch your dumb reviews. And we were like, yes, thanks, bro.
That's cute.
Yeah, man, this show is whatever. I'll say this though, man. I actually like this better than this. In the beginning, I hated the episode. I was like, this is, God damn it. I don't care about Troy. Jake is a bitch. I don't. And then it got a little interesting. You know, it
in
got a little
way.
Interesting. Well, I actually thought the stuff with Troy and Jake and Nick was actually something. It was something, you know, it was a story. It was something. So Troy comes back, let's start with the fact that Troy is going out of his mind. Is he going to kill himself? We don't know. Probably not.
I wish he was going to like fucking 18 times this throughout the episode. I'm like, oh my God, when are you just going to do it? You know?
He goes to Walker's ranch, and it turns out that he finds a horde.
Right? Yes.
Fucking little bitch. And then he goes and then he's like surprises
Nick. He goes crazy.
I love how he locked him out of the house, and Nick's just like, oh, I'll just fucking jump over the balcony and go downstairs.
And, yeah, it's not like the windows gone. Weren't shot out. And,
see, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. They have like these ideas, but the execution of these ideas are just dumb as shit. They're just dumb. Like,
weird.
Anyway, I don't know about you, man. What'd you think about the Troy Nick, the love triangle that they had going on there?
I mean, I think it's a little weird for what Nick did to, you know, Troy's family and Jake's family, and not for nothing, Jake found out, and Jake's like, I don't care, you know, like, I don't know, for something as big as what Nick did, I thought that they would have. There would have been more of a feud.
I think it's because, well, Troy understands it and accepts it for a different reason than Jake does. Jake is done. He tells Alicia in the beginning of the episode he wants to leave, right?
Yeah,
he wants to get out of there.
Place in the mountains or something.
They have a cabin somewhere in the desert, he says, right?
Yeah.
And he wants to leave and whatever. And then he picks a fight with her and she's like, well, whatever, dude. And then he takes, and then whatever. So then him and Nick go to find Troy. They find Troy, and it's like, but dude, the fact that they're driving and they see the herd, they see this, you know, the smoke.
Hey.
But then wait, they stop exactly where Troy is. They happen to look, they're like, oh, and they look down, and there's Troy. And he just turns around and he's like, hey, guys.
Hi.
Like, really? Yeah, like, what? Like, no, you didn't stop. You didn't see him. He was over a ridge. You didn't see him.
Yeah, I guess they were that close because they did mention that they were very close that last time when Troy shot the, you know, the grenade launcher or whatever the fuck that thing was, which was a pretty badass weapon. But
well, I guess, but
you know how that would be such an advantageous weapon in the apocalypse. You can take out however many,
and he's using it to lure.
At one time. Yeah, and he's just luring.
So where did he get it from?
Did he take it from?
Oh, he saw it at Walker's Ranch.
At
remember,
Walker's
he,
Ranch
he found
or something,
the,
right?
the hidden door, or whatever the hell that was. Yeah,
I don't know. My favorite part probably is the scene where we've seen all those walkers. Because at first I'm like, what the fuck is that? Because you just saw all the dust kicked up. I'm like, what the fuck is he doing out there?
Yeah.
Is he running? You know.
Yeah.
So it's kind of funny because we were talking about this, and I talked about this myself last week. How. You know, well, we both have spoken about how it's all about the humans, and this is kind of a little bit of a breath of fresh air that we actually
got to have
a large amount of walkers.
And you know, because the walkers in this are not any threat, like everybody can take these things out willy nilly. I mean, yes, so can the people on the original show, but they've worked for it, like
many?
They worked towards it.
Yeah.
And they've lost people in the process.
Yeah.
So like we've seen them grow into these roles of zombie killers. It goes to tell you
that they should have done a lot. They should have been taking a lot more time fortifying
the ranch
from further out and further out and further out. Just go as you know, just keep in however many feet or whatever increments of building a fence and to just to fortify it, because obviously there really wasn't much, and the walkers came through. Let me ask you this: what do you think about their little plan for the fucking with all the RVs? Like,
no, dude, I'm like, what? Like, what are you? That's not. First of all right, dude, I got. All right, here's a couple. All right, there's a couple things. First of all, that was dumb. I get the idea that they were trying to lure them away, but then that didn't work, dude. And then all of a sudden they've got 28 days later zombies jumping out from underneath the. That's not. I'm sorry, but that what was that, dude?
I thought it was a little. Yeah, I thought it was ridiculous. I thought it was like an homage to Walking Dead with the rock quarry when all the walkers were coming from the rock quarry and Rick tried to line up a perimeter that they would kind of lead them out.
Right.
And I thought that's what they would do.
It was supposed to be that way.
Well, I don't think that they said, all right, you and you, we're going to lure them.
No, they didn't lure them. Right. They just let them
waited for them to fucking come and push like over the
bunch of morons. Like nobody, RV. Right. Nobody lured them. They just did that. But then again, and I don't know what you think
was going to happen. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, dude. And it really bothered me when they started jumping out from underneath. Like, it wasn't like they were like coming from underneath. They were like, rah, like they were that one dude shot out from underneath. And I'm like, what the hell? That's not canon, man. That wasn't canon. That's not part of what this world is. Mm-hmm. Ugh, whatever. I digress.
That's not how they act. No, but so, yeah, no, I thought it was a little. I thought it was a stupid idea.
But then, since we're talking about that attack, I still thought it was the overall. Finally, we get a zombie attack in this zombie apocalypse show. Finally, we get a horde. Yeah. We get a group of people, like we get some real tension, some real, instead of just a bunch of idiots pointing guns at each other. You know what I'm saying?
No, I mean, like I said, it's a breath of fresh air with that.
I wouldn't call it fresh air, bro. It probably more musty, decaying air, but I get what you're saying.
It was Walker air.
Where you go, Walker air. Fresh air.
It was Walker air. It was cool. It was all right. Like, I didn't like the beginning scenes with Troy, not the initial scene, but the scene where it comes back to the ranch. I just didn't like his job when he was locking Nick out of the house. I thought it was kind of stupid, like you said. But I mean, now what are they going to do? That's really the big question of this: is what are they going to do now? Because how is Nick and unfortunately Jake dies. I mean, we can get into that, but it's what, how is Nick going to get in there and rescue his sister and the rest of the group that are locked now in this cellar where they store, you know, the storage cellar.
The pantry. I know, dude. I just assumed, I was just waiting for the water truck to come blasting through.
I agree.
With the three of them.
But there was so many walkers, which was cool, that when I saw the amount that were coming, I'm like, what is Madison going to fucking do? I mean, it's kind of funny because, you know, their whole mission was to get the water, because they thought they had 6 weeks. They're lucky they had 6 days or a few days, because they didn't realize that, number one, that there was this much. Let me ask you this. Do you think that this group, this horde would have stumbled upon them regardless? Or you just think just because what Troy did is the only reason they came upon the ranch?
I don't think they would have found them, because they were all there anyway. It's not like the walkers were moving in that direction. They were all just there. They didn't show us, but I assume they were all just milling about, because there's nothing out there. What are they chasing? There's nothing out there.
Yeah, I mean,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
all of Walker's people, the nation is now at the ranch. There's nobody at the nation's compound. So there's nobody there to keep them there. I mean, and then there's a lot of questions like where did that horde come from? Were they already there? They never showed us. We were on that rock already before.
Yeah, is there another place? You know, is it another jail, prison kind of? Idea that this show is going to kind of go with, because now listen, I'm assuming that from this episode that we're gonna lose the ranch. Maybe maybe Nick will swoop in with that grenade launcher
didn't
thing.
Didn't they say that? Somebody did say that. Somebody said that there are other places. Didn't
I think Alicia said there's got to be other places like this or something like that along those lines. I'm pretty sure when she was talking with Jake, or maybe Jake said it to her or something. One of the two.
Jake said it to her.
Yeah.
Anyway, I mean, yeah. So I'll tell you this much though. Mm. If it's not Madison saves the day situation next episode. Oh, you know what I didn't do? I didn't watch the coming attractions. See, we're talking about this and we didn't even see the coming attractions, but you know what? We're going to talk out our ass anyway. So having seen the coming attractions,
a little eerie portion of it.
I usually watch that and I feel dumb now because whatever. Anyway, point is, I bet you it's going to be dumb. Instead of making it like a really cool, like, oh my God, I can't believe they got out of it this way. It's going to be like, oh, that was how they got out of it. Of course they did.
Well, I think it's going to be something like, you know, Nick and Troy are there. And who comes around the corner is Madison and Walker with the truck. What's going on? Oh my God, my daughter's in trouble. The people are in trouble. Blah,
I'm
going to
go get her. I'm going to go get her. And she's just going to go in and
so
gung-ho.
I think that grenade launcher thing will have something to play. Maybe it'll give them enough time. Maybe they'll lure them. Maybe they'll use the Walking Dead trick of the sound and the noise because they kind of mentioned.
Well, they did it already. That's how we got them there.
Yeah, but just to. Yeah, exactly. To do that, or maybe they'll just explode a bunch of them.
Who knows? All I know is that you're in the bunker. And you're all standing there, and in the front of that group is a mother with her child.
Yeah,
and I'm like,
a few kids.
But I'm like, why? I wouldn't have my kid right in the doorway. I'd have that thing in the back of the fucking bunker. Like, what are you doing?
They were staring at Alicia like, almost. Did you get it? Almost like it's their fault or something. I don't know. It kind of.
No, well, you know, they say.
Or is it just a frightened?
I think they're afraid. Like, oh, fuck. You know, speaking of Alicia, there was a couple of interesting things. So. Man, I'm to this show, man. So let's talk very specifically Alicia and how she was fighting. I enjoyed how the fact that she took like half a second to like fire. And then when the guy got overrun, the big dude, he got overrun, she lines up and waits like a second and then fires to make sure, like, to me that was like, oh, she was making sure she's good. She was going to get that headshot.
Yeah.
You know, like that was really cool. But then after that, when the three of them, when... What's that guy's name again?
Something dog or something.
Wild dog, nasty dog. What's his name? Big dog?
Road dog or something.
Road dog. I don't know. Yeah, that guy. Nate dog. That's it. So when Nate dog, Alicia, and...
It was T-Dog.
T-Dog. Nah, man. That dude, no. R.I.P. T-Dog. R.I.P. But when, you know, and what's her name again? Ophelia.
Ophelia.
So when the three of them are literally overrun.
Oh, my God.
There was a moment where I was like, oh, shit. Then all of a sudden, they've thinned it out. And he's he's pulling like a, like an Elektra move, like Elektra, you know, like Marvel's Elektra. He's got the two blades and he's like spinning around them and hit him in the stomach. Why are you hitting them in the stomach and then like, like he's doing all these moves on them.
Yeah.
You don't have time to fucking be a fucking like a superhero out there.
It's
Why
not,
are you hitting them in the gut with a blade that does nothing to them? You're wasting your energy and you could possibly lose the blade. Like, what the fuck are you doing?
Where was everybody else, really? It seemed like there was a shitload of people in that fucking bunker. Where were they helping out?
They weren't. And they got them all to the bunker.
I guess they,
She tells Alicia, they'll follow you. Go. And then Alicia's just yelling at them to get in.
And Alicia really saved Ophelia's ass. I mean,
she did.
I don't know. It was funny because while I was seeing, during that scene, I was, you know, Alicia had this machete and she's like pulling this fucking machete straight through the top of this fucking walker.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that is like, these people do not realize what kind of weapons you should have for quick brain kills and that's it. You should have a nice little 6-inch knife or something like that, something that you can just boom and take out. She's using a fucking machete that's 2 feet long.
Right.
Yeah. I'm like, it's just the kind of weapons that they had and that they were.
They're not prepared. Like, you are not prepared to fight
this. That's the wrong thing
to
have.
Wait,
you're
Ophelia.
You're better off with a fucking screwdriver
or something. Ophelia, later on, she pulls out she pulls out like a hammer like she had previously.
Yeah.
But before that, she's got this big stick, and
she has a stick.
There's only like two shots of like they she had like taped a spike to it. I'm like, why does she have
a? Did she had a wooden. Did she sharpen
it was
it
a wooden. No, dude, it looked like it was all taped up, man. Yeah. Like Dead Rising or something, you know, like the game. But dude, I'm like, why is she holding a 2x4? What the hell? And they all have like M16s and you know ARs, and she's got this 2x4, and I'm like, what the fuck, dude? Yeah. Man, I'm telling you, literally nobody was prepared. Then you have Alicia just staring at them. She's looking out in between the trucks. And she's watching them get, what the hell? And then the thing comes out from underneath. I'm like, I can't. So again, the situations when on paper sound really good, but their execution on this show,
I don't know why, man. Continually,
they were saying in the comments on the last video, the characters remain to be the dumbest bunch of asshats in this apocalypse. Now let's go. I want to go back to Jake real quick because I really did it. I did enjoy. Okay, let me put this as succinctly as I can. I hate Jake. I think he's such a little pussy. I hate Troy. He's also a pussy bitch. But and I hate them together. But I enjoyed the scene because it was hilarious to me. That kid is he's on top of his brother crying. Right, he's like, I'm gonna kill you. And he's like, do it. And then he's like, oh, why don't you tell him what you did? Just, it was so ridiculous. But I liked it. I don't know why. And I knew Nick was going to clock this kid, right? Then all of a sudden, he gets bit by a zombie. I'm like, oh,
well, how many
my
times
God.
Is Nick going to save fucking Troy? I think I'd rather have fucking... Now you're going to have this so-called, like, redemption arc that they're going to throw at you.
He's a lunatic.
You know he's going to survive now because when they rescue Alicia and the group, they're going to be like, oh, my God, you're the one that got us into this mess in the first place.
Yeah, exactly.
That's exactly how it's going to be. Then you're going to have Madison jumping in the middle.
I can already hear her dumb voice. Yeah.
You're going to have Madison
like,
jumping in there going, oh I'll take care of him.
Yeah.
If he does
I'll
anything
do it.
Wrong, it'll be my fault.
I can fix this.
I can watch him. Yeah. But,
oh
I mean,
my God!
Dude,
we just wrote the next three episodes, Mike.
Yeah,
we just wrote the
exactly
next three episodes.
That's exactly what it is.
We did it. We're done.
Because you know it's very predictable. We know where they're going with it.
Oh my God!
I wish Troy would have fucking. I wish Jake would have shot his brother.
Yep.
You know.
Yep.
Bang! All right, mother. Like that's it. And I don't know. You know, maybe in the scrum. You know, Walker comes and grabs him because not for nothing, that Walker got onto them like quick, fast. Like all of a sudden, the Walker's
all of a sudden
like,
he's
like,
there.
On them.
That's what I'm saying. He
like,
rolled down.
Like,
he's
Nick
there.
Hits him. The guy rolls down a hill, fucking 5 feet, and there's a fucking Walker there.
Yeah.
Maybe you should have, you know. So I mean, it's
a fucking Walker there.
Yeah, it's tough, man. It's tough. You know, but all the weak people usually die. That's exactly what Alicia said to Jake, you know, about why do you like me kind of a thing, because you're the last decent guy in the planet or whatever the fuck. Like, you know, why did you bang me that night? I wasn't gonna do it.
Yeah,
I thought you were doing it just so you like shut up, dude.
Exactly, man. I'm gonna tell
you, hottest piece of fucking tail in the whole fucking apocalypse, because she is badass, but like just shut up. Stop acting like a little douche.
But that's
nozzle.
The thing, and they got the perfect actor to do it because he's like this pretty boy
little
bitch.
Pretty boy little dude. Yeah.
But wait, but then I did enjoy. See, there's these little nuggets, man. There's this little bit, these little tiny
nuggets.
Little nuggets that shine through. I like the fact that he died. They didn't say anything about it. They were just like, oh, you gotta have to take care of him now. Like,
yeah.
I like the fact that he died in the mix of everything. And they didn't go, oh, my God, he died. But, like, so they chopped his arm off to try and save him, and it didn't. And he just died anyway. Like, they couldn't get back. That was cool. We need more of that. We need more of those moments where, this could be a positive thing. We could get this guy here. But then, boom, guess what? Oh, shit, that's not going to happen. And he dies. Like, that's the stuff I want to see.
I mean, they did bring back to remember when we first saw Troy and everything to begin with. Remember he had the tally? Because they showed him in the book in the first scene. He was writing in the book and stuff. But it was funny how Nick was like, how long do you think it's going to take, bro?
Yeah.
You know, and he's like, I don't know.
Yeah,
you know,
right.
And,
like,
Yeah, so
everything
it was
is so
funny
forced. It's all so forced, and it's like
it was. I mean, I don't want to keep ripping it, and I mean that's all we've been doing.
Look, The Walking Dead can't come back fucking fast enough, man.
Absolutely. I mean, what else is there to say? I think, like we said, we summed up what the next couple episodes, at least
definitely
the next
did,
episode, yeah. is going to be. You know, Madison with a stank face is going to come around the corner.
Alicia's going to yell at someone and
yeah.
make everyone
Alicia's
see the light.
Alicia's
going to
be mad.
Yeah.
We'll see how she deals with Jake's death now. And that's how it's going to be. That's going to be Alicia now. Alicia's going to deal with, let's do a little like theory of the characters in these next couple episodes. So Troy with the redemption thing, he's going to have his
right.
little arc. Madison's going to protect him. Alicia may be mad at Nick because, you know, Nick was supposed to protect. He even said it, I'll protect your boyfriend.
Right.
Obviously, that didn't happen. And it's his fault, really, that Nick got bit in the first
right.
place. What else? So Alicia will – how do you think Alicia will act towards
– Yeah, she's gonna end up being – she's going to turn inside herself now. She's
yeah.
going to be like – yeah, she's going to be mad at Nick, but then she's also going to be like – or you know what, man? She might be like relieved. Like, oh my God! Thank God this fucking guy.
Well, we'll see.
Like,
we'll see how. We'll see how she. How truly she really liked him or loved him or whatever yeah. to the extent of that. But you know, depending
listen,
on how,
listen,
how well she
acts. Listen, Alicia's like her mom. Alicia's mom is a user, dude. She's a manipulative user. Like she.
Well, I think she legitimately liked him. I don't think
no,
she
no,
was
that,
with
I,
him.
I yeah, but she's also a user, dude. She's learned how to manipulate like her mom does. Her mom is like the biggest manipulator.
They all kind of have that. I think they all kind of
even Nick.
Have
you're
that.
Right. Yeah, they even do. Yeah.
Nick with the way he acts towards Troy. Let me talk to him. That's the same thing Madison really
yeah.
would have done.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Nick is probably more similar to Madison than even Alicia is. I think Alicia still. Isn't to that point, but I wonder. You know, listen. What do you think, Walker? How do you think Walker is going to react to now?
Oh, he's going to be, dude. It's going to be, it's going to be hilarious because he's like he just got this ranch back, right?
Yeah.
And
now
it's fucking gone. It's completely gone. So,
yeah. so we'll
maybe
see.
They'll
I
go
mean,
back to his place. But what? I don't know, dude. I gotta look.
I think
at
they're gonna be on the road.
I gotta look at the I gotta look at the. You know, we gotta watch that after this. We should just watch
yeah.
it. We say all these things, and I don't know what the hell's going to happen in the next episode, but it doesn't matter. So, I don't know, man.
Anyway.
Yeah, whatever. Let's just end the damn thing. I think we've said everything. You know, let us know what you guys think.
Let us know in the comments, of course.
I mean,
course,
we already know what
to
you
the
think.
Video
you know, here's the thing. I did notice that, like, when we first started the Fear of the Walking Dead last year, people were on board. Like, a lot of people were watching it. But now, like, it's dropped off, man. Like, people that are watching these videos have dropped off because
yeah.
it's like no one's watching this show. No one cares.
It's
you
true.
Know? And
well,
I can't
you know,
blame
no,
them.
I can't blame them either. But maybe what we can do next week, maybe between the time we do the next video, we can – one of us will find the viewership and how many viewers we have and kind of give it a number to what we – you know, what we theorize, how many people are watching. But yeah, listen, it's tough. We've spoke about this on every single one of our videos. So if you want to hear our previous rants for the past season of these, you know, this third season, just watch some of those other videos. You might get a kick out of our rants, but you know, leave your comments below the videos and always, you know, you can always find us, of course, on Third Person Pod on all the social medias on Instagram. And on Facebook, you can leave your comments there as well. And don't forget to check out and have a listen to us on iTunes, Third Person.
Yep. Oh, yeah, we also have thirdpersonpod.com. That's the thing. Yeah, we have a website. It's a blog site, but it's, yeah.
You'll find us. Just type it in. You'll find us.
Anyway, that's it. Whatever. Just go check out retrosquat.com. It's another podcast I do. It's funny. That's it, guys. So until next week when we see what happens. I mean, but I am legit interested to see what happens now. Like, I'm going to watch it because
I want to
know where it's going to go. It's going to be dumb
exactly.
as shit regardless, but I want to know where it's going to go.
I'm hoping if any episode, this savior kind of episode and how they're going to get them out of there, because you know they're going to get them out of there.
Yeah.
You know what would be funny? There's going to be like a, not to, you know, prolong this, but there'll be that secret passage out the back of the tunnel. Oh, I forgot.
Yeah.
There's a passage in the back.
Troy knows. Troy's going to know where it is. I'll get them out. I know where it is.
There's a, you know. It's gonna be funny, but I can see if any episode I'm gonna be a little bit give some kind of positive vibe for next week, episode 13. Hopefully, it's one of the better episodes of the season.
Yeah, definitely. All right, so that's it, guys. Thank you very much. We love you, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace out.
Peace.